업계를 선도하는 국내외 유망 기업 혹은 인물들 만나 얘기 나눠보는 프론티어 인터뷰 시간입니다. 저희 오늘은 60억 명을 위한 모바일 엔터테인먼트를 모토로 하는 기업이죠. 볼트의 공동 창립자이자 CCO인 크리스 오펙스 모셔보시고 저희 말씀 나눠보는 시간 가져보도록 하겠습니다. Hey, Crystal, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here.
Thank you for coming. So before you begin, typical way to start, could you introduce yourself to our viewers, please?
Sure. So hi, my name is Crystal, and I'm the co-founder and chief commercial officer of Bolt Global. We aim to be the largest mobile wallet in the world that's powered by content.
I see. So let's get down to the project talk now.
Sure, no
So let's
problem.
Start talking about what kind of project Bolt is.
Yeah.
So it's Bolt, such a strong name, Bolt.
It's fast and keeps you bolted to your phone, and that's why we thought of it. Well, actually, I can't take credit for that because my co-founder and CEO actually thought of that name.
Oh.
But I happen to be the person to try and bring our mission and vision and tie it all back together to what we want to do.
I see. Okay, so what kind of project is?
So it has a mobile entertainment element. It's built on the blockchain. It's in fact powered by Zilliqa, which is the fastest and most public blockchain in the world. Small disclosure, I am an advisor to Zilliqa as well. So we actually want to use content to power the mobile wallet transactions, which is a shoot with the Bolt token. And that's how we're going to be the biggest mobile wallet in the world because we're using high premium velocity sporting moments like the 2019 Cricket World Cup, which has an audience of almost 1 billion people, and the Champions League highlights, the English Premier League highlights, and I mean, football is huge, right?
Huge.
Massive, massive. And we want to bring all these match highlights 2 hours after the match onto the platform, and the only way you can access that is through the Bolt token.
Oh, I see, I see. It sounds interesting. We'll go deep in there.
Definitely.
So what actually motivated you to start this Bolt project then?
So when I think about the blockchain, right, I see it as the fourth wave of the internet. So the internet has gone through four different waves in total. The first wave was actually email, and that broke down the geographic barrier because it allowed anyone to send a message to anyone anywhere else in the world, saving time and saving cost, right? The second wave was social media, right? And social media basically broke down the communication barrier, like Facebook, for example, and allowed anyone to just communicate effectively with your social graph. The third wave was the sharing economy, and that broke the economic barrier, actually, and that allowed anyone to create a new economy and decide when and where they want to work, like Uber, for example. The next wave, which is the blockchain economy, I believe is going to democratize the chain between content users and content producers, and you allow anyone to become a content producer, anyone to consume and create content, and also to take part in premium content plays like, you know, your live football matches, you know, and that is a huge movement in itself, right? And when we looked at the internet industry today, we realized that Facebook and YouTube, for example, they were free to access, but however, they would sacrifice your user data and privacy in order to make the platform free because you've got to run advertising, right? Then Netflix is really, really good. I mean, it has a lot of great long-form content. I'm sure we'll talk about that later in a moment. But it's very expensive to access.
It is.
Right? And your football, like live football leagues and World Cup, it's very expensive to access from a cable TV standpoint also. So that's the problem.
Oh, I see, I see. I get it. So we'll go deep in there more. But before we actually talk about the project more about it, I want to talk about you.
Oh, thank you.
So I heard that you're very specialized in marketing.
Yes.
Well, there's this huge, your past work experience. You have been included in The Guardian magazine's top 10 global digital strategists. And Twitter, the Business Insider picked you as a top 30 executives that you should follow on Twitter. And you said yourself that you were advisor of Zilliqa and Switzerland. So you're definitely leading female marketing that the whole world is watching. So let's talk about your past work experience and how you being end up this industry.
So it's very funny for me because I think Bolt has become the culmination of all my previous experiences into one. I started out as a digital marketer in social media. In fact, I worked on the one of the first Facebook and Twitter marketing campaigns for one of the leading banks in Singapore when Facebook was just like a really tiny three-person office in Singapore for Asia. So I remember when they were actually in the service office.
Oh, wow.
Then I actually worked at Samsung as well.
Okay.
So I was leading social business for Samsung across 12 markets based out of Singapore.
Mm-hmm.
And then after I went to Twitter and I became head of content.
Mm-hmm.
So I was kind of in that social business, commercialization, digital strategy, and look at how we can actually make the distance between brands and users shorter, more efficient, and more rewarding for both sides.
And
I ran a data company as well in Asia, which was Brandwatch, and thereafter became the advisor to Zilliqa right before their initial coin offering last year in December.
Interesting.
Yes.
So okay, let's talk about Bolt then. What's the special features that we can find on on Bolt platform? Like what kind of services that that we can expect from Bolt?
So basically on Bolt, right, we've signed up over 30 content creators in our pilot program in East Africa, and I was just in Kenya 2 weeks ago before coming to Korea.
It must be so warm there.
It was so warm compared to the cold in Korea, I must say. But it was so interesting for us because I think over there, right, a lot of people are uploading content onto YouTube, but what then happens is that you're getting only $700-800 for over 10 million views. It doesn't even cover the cost of your equipment. And we're saying to them, look, continue uploading your videos onto YouTube, but if you want to earn more money and also build a closer interaction with your fans, upload the same content onto Bolt, as long as they're 5 minutes and under, because we want to keep it to short form content.
Right.
Your users, your customers can actually tip you in even in fiat, in Korean won, in BTC, or even in a Bolt token. But if they tip you in a Bolt token and you hold more Bolt tokens, we'll take a smaller cut of your earnings every single month. That's for the content producer, because our mission is to democratize the chain between users and content producers. To realize the vision of becoming the world's largest mobile wallet that's powered by content, we want to bring the best sporting events that was only available historically on cable TV, bring it all into the platform. And how we actually do that is we've been negotiating with these big name sporting leagues like Champions League, English Premier League, the International Cricket Council. So we are the official 2019 broadcast partner of the International Cricket Council on mobile. So it's very exciting for us, and that will give us access
to
1 billion people. So I can't wait to bring the Bolt token to all of these guys.
That's huge.
Thank you.
So we talked about your platform and the services. And now I wonder, so for real users like me, how do we actually use this Bolt platform?
So we want to make it simple, because I've always believed that, you see, for the blockchain, right, it's always been in the hands of enterprises. It's not been easy for a user to use if you don't have a private key, you don't have a ledger wallet. So what we want to do there is really quite simple. We're going to bundle these tokens as credits with your mobile data plans. So you can go to SKT today, you can go to, you know, Digi in Malaysia, for example.
Right.
When you buy a 1 gigabyte data plan, it comes preloaded with 3 Bolt tokens, which allows you to access the Bolt ecosystem for 1 month. So no private key, but when you redeem the token in the Bolt ecosystem, you cannot withdraw the token for trading. So that's how we eliminate that speculative element as well.
Makes sense.
Yeah,
okay, so
very simple.
So well, we talked about that you were advisor of Zilliqa, but there must be reason that you actually chose Zilliqa, right?
Well, other than the fact that I really believe the team and I love them a lot. I mean, they have an incredible work ethic. Yeah, it is an interesting platform. I think why we chose them as well is because they're the only blockchain platform today that really actually supports our high throughput use case. You see, a lot of blockchain platforms out there, they claim they can do 1 million transactions per second, but that's across 20 nodes or 20 computers, and everything can be off the chain and not really on the blockchain. But what we want to do is to have all of these transactions to be as transparent as possible, to be audited when necessary, and that to us has been a principal tenet of our vision and also our values as a company. We in fact want to see how we could even slowly decentralize our involvement, because at the end of the day, to make this a truly decentralized movement and put the platform back into the hands of the users, we have to become a decentralized autonomous organization. So I think that is further down the roadmap, I would say, but you know, we can discuss that if needed.
I see. Okay, got yeah. it. So let's talk about the Bolt own strengths then, because yes. you know, what's your own strengths compared to your competitors, such as we can say, let's say YouTube yes. or there was Alpha Network. He was yeah. like sitting right there.
Yo.
What's your own strengths then?
Yeah. No, I think you know, different blockchain platforms mm-hmm. have, I mean, obviously their own use cases.
Right.
Otherwise, they wouldn't want to write their white paper or be in the business.
True.
So what Alpha is doing is interesting because they want to be the Netflix on the blockchain.
Netflix on the blockchain.
Yeah, it is. I mean, that's what they want to be, right?
That's true.
I think. And you know, kudos to them for that.
Mm-hmm.
I think our focus is not on long form content.
Okay.
We're on short form content.
Mm.
We're on data efficient content. And we want to make our revenue model as efficient as possible. I mean, look at Netflix today. They just did a $12 billion debt round at a 6% coupon rate redeemable after 10 years, which means they need to actually pay back $12 billion plus 6% after in the next 10 years.
Uh-huh.
After 10 years, yeah.
Oh,
so
okay.
in this field, right, mm-hmm. of original production,
right.
it's really, really expensive,
mm-hmm.
especially if you're investing in long-form movie standard content. It's not cheap at all.
It's not
cheap at all. No. I mean, look at The Crown on Netflix, you know, all the beautiful architecture
it's
and
true.
Set. It's expensive.
It is expensive.
So, I mean, I'm sure they'll find their ways to make money.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, platforms like, you know, Alpha Network, you know, VideoCoin, everything else, I think, gives awareness to what we want to do because everyone recognizes that we all have a similar problem. And I think at Bolt, what we want to do as our mission
mm-hmm.
is to democratize the chain between content user and content producer, and we want to make it as accessible as possible to everyone. And that's why we look at Africa, emerging markets, and we have over 3 million users right now across Africa, emerging markets in Asia, and we've done over 240,000 Android app installs alone in the last 2 months.
In the last 2 months?
Yes,
That's actually amazing.
Yeah, thank you.
Wow,
thank you so much. Yeah.
So we briefly talked about the Bolt tokens, but
yes.
let's get into more details of this token economy of Bolt.
Yes, sure. So the Bolt token economy is quite simple. When
mm-hmm.
you enter the ecosystem for the first time,
okay.
you can use fiat, which is
right.
a mobile wallet, or your credit card if you want to,
mm-hmm.
and pay for that $1 a month to access the Bolt ecosystem.
Mm-hmm.
But if you use the Bolt token, you get a 50% discount in the first year, very similar to the Binance model where they use the BNB token as a subsidy for trading fees. So that's the first step. The second step is if you actually came in through a telco because you bought your 1 gigabyte of data with the 3 Bolt tokens for 1 month,
mm-hmm.
then you can just immediately redeem it by entering a redemption code
mm-hmm.
and you're in the ecosystem.
Mm.
When you're in the ecosystem, you can choose a couple of things. There will be certain sections which are token only, like the football content, like the cricket content,
right.
and you can also use it to do data boosting top-ups. So what we're working with the telcos right now is that we want to make available micro packets of data because you might run out of data suddenly. And you know, if you're in an emerging market, you don't want to have to run out to a convenience store to go and get another 1 gigabyte of data. But you can use your Bolt tokens to redeem that and boost your data balance. So that's the first step. And then thereafter, if you want to earn more tokens besides buying the tokens together with the telco
okay.
with the data plan, you can do things like subtitling content, moderating content as well, which will be really, really great because it creates a whole new economy with the ecosystem.
Mm.
And that's why we talk about being the largest mobile wallet in the world powered by content, because
right.
the content is by the user. And that's how it drives the whole economy. And that's why we want to be, I mean, I don't know, it's like a combination of PayPal and Netflix only for the emerging markets. So we haven't really found that analogy, but
mm-hmm.
the best vision we can think of is largest mobile wallet powered by content.
Ah, we'll talk about that later.
Yeah.
Okay, so now sure. let's talk about, well, you know, there are like hundreds, thousands of projects out there.
Yes,
and
there
like for us, like, you know, investors or just users.
Yes.
When we choose project or study project,
yeah.
when you go into the white paper and there's the section that we always look at, the team members.
Team members, yes.
I'll let you brag about your team members.
Yeah, I mean, our team, you know, we're 12 nationalities across
mm-hmm.
4 offices and we have about 30 people right now.
Wow.
And our management team is really, really strong. I mean, we have people from Twitter, my founder and CEO actually, he used to run TV networks and broadcast networks, you know, all across Asia
wow.
and even in Africa as well. which was really exciting for us. Our advisory board was very exciting because we have the former head of aerospace program at Facebook, mm-hmm. who is an advisor of ours, Elliot Tarbold. We have Trevor Healy, who is a seasoned M&A expert, and he recently, you know, did a huge deal selling, you know, Belkin to Foxconn, for example. And of course, we have Leon Kim here in Korea,
yes.
who is amazing in his own
charming
right.
Charming guy.
Charming, very charming gentleman, a partner at Bitsonic Labs, and also running his own consultancy on the blockchain. Mm-hmm. So really well-rounded team across the world, and we just want to come together because we're united by the same mission to do more and democratize access to the emerging markets.
Oh. Oh, wow, that's amazing members.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
So let's talk about the current stage of Bolt, the word
yes.
Bolt now.
Yeah.
What kind of stage is it?
So we are already a live product,
okay.
but we're working to build the wallet function mm-hmm. on the blockchain, which is including experiments currently on Zilliqa's testnet,
mm.
because Zilliqa's mainnet, it will go live in Q1 2019.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I would say that we'll be ready to launch in Q1 2019, but more excitingly, what's going to happen is this. We actually are now in the finalization of an agreement to pre-install the Bolt app across 6 million devices for the number one TV manufacturer in South Africa.
6 million devices?
Yeah, 6 wow. million devices, yeah. So, I mean, we met them and they really liked us so much that we're probably going to develop a standalone TV app running on Linux just for them,
mm-hmm.
because we want to bring the Bolt token to all these markets in South Africa, huge market, by the way, and the smart TVs there are bundled with data plans by the telcos,
mm-hmm.
massive potential for us, and that's when I think the pilot would escalate onto more markets, because they're not just present in South Africa, they're the number three TV manufacturer in the US presently.
Wow. There's numbers out of your mouth. It's just amazing.
Oh,
wow,
thank you.
Amazing numbers. Okay.
Thank you.
So, well, we talked about your amazing members and your current stage. So mm. now I wonder, how are you doing your partnership?
Partnerships.
Yeah.
Oh, when we concluded our private contribution round in
mm-hmm.
June, we didn't rest on our laurels. And as we know, the crypto market has taken a fair bit of beating.
Yeah.
We actually used that time to really focus a lot.
Mm-hmm.
My founder, CEO, and myself, right,
mm-hmm.
we led our team to close more new partnerships in more new markets to show that for the blockchain to really go mainstream, you need to adapt the blockchain as a blockchain invisibility.
Right.
Right. It's like, you know, when you're uploading a photo onto Facebook, you don't really care about what protocol it's running on.
No.
You just want to put the photo up. Same for someone in an emerging market.
Right.
I just want to watch my cricket content.
That's true.
So we've done a partnership with Digi, the largest telco in Malaysia.
Okay.
It has 11 million subscribers. One of our first pilots, I think, to bundle our Bolt token with the data plans.
Wow.
A partnership with Safaricom,
mm-hmm.
largest telco in Kenya already, 36 million subscribers there. Another partnership with a financial institution out in Asia. And this is a funny one because they are actually going to use our token to reward their users
oh.
for actually being a loyal customer of that particular financial institution.
Wow.
So I thought that was actually really interesting because a traditional financial institution is now using us, powered by the blockchain,
right.
to reward their customers.
Wow. That's
yeah.
That's
just
something.
Some of the partnerships
yeah.
that we've done.
I
so
see,
far.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay. So where do you see the future of the combination of entertainment and blockchain technologies?
I think a lot of the access and the control will be handed back to the user.
Mm.
And I think you can see that at the start of social media because, you know, more content was produced more by users that
mm-hmm.
have propelled the platform
mm-hmm.
versus the brands.
Okay.
I think for the blockchain and the entertainment industry to work well together,
okay.
we would really need for us, I think, to open it up to the emerging markets. Because a lot of the focus has been on developed markets.
Mm-hmm.
And the developed markets, they have choice because
mm.
they have more resources, they have more cash. But in emerging markets, because the resources are so constrained, and it's often more difficult to crack because of local partnerships need local distributors and local agreements, it will require, I think, a global mindset with a local attitude.
Mm.
And that's how I think a blockchain can be applied to entertainment because entertainment is local, but
yes.
with a global voice.
Local with a global voice.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
Yes.
That's That's very attractive. I personally think that's very attractive. Okay.
Thank you.
This could be the last question and the question that I'm most curious about.
Sure.
So we talked about this largest content-powered mobile wallet.
Yes.
How do you have it happen?
How did we think about that? It's because, you mean the clarification of the vision?
Vision, future plans.
Yeah.
You know, everything.
You know, it's funny because when we built out this project, we never knew what it could turn out to be because we just set out to bring all this content to the masses in emerging markets, mm-hmm. right? And then after that, we started recording all these transactions. I mean, right now we've recorded over 21 million transactions a year alone. And this is not even on the blockchain yet. This is not even with all the high premium sporting events. And then we realized that, hey, actually, we have become a de facto mobile wallet. And instead of us spending money to acquire customers and making them re-engage to use our platform through discounts and subsidies, we're using content. And they're doing it naturally. And that's how we just started seeing ourselves as actually a mobile wallet that's powered by content. That's really what it is. And I think that is the vision that we want to do. So anything that is related to what we want to do as a company, an ecosystem, and even signing up partners is geared towards that vision.
It's amazing.
To reach the next 6 billion,
as
I like to
say. Wow, next 6 billion.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Thank you.
Okay, so really, for the last, if you want to leave any comments to our viewers, please do so.
I think I'll look at the camera now.
Okay.
So I've been very heartened by the reception we've received in South Korea. And a lot of it has been facilitated by our partners on the ground, including our advisor, Leon Kim. And we were just at the Bigosu Crypto Festival over the weekend. And I presented our vision to the community, and we had, you know, sign-ups and, you know, people coming to ask about our project on Kakao Talk. So I would say that thank you so much for your enthusiasm, and we look forward to really growing our partnership and presence here in South Korea, which will be a very important market for us, even in the content partnership space, in the blockchain and crypto community, and we look forward to see what there is to come.
I was bold. Thank you for coming to Space the Closure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.